It's that time of the year again, where the week-long harvest festival of Pongal meets Jallikattu, the bull-taming sport of Tamil Nadu. This controversial sport involves a bull that is set free inside an arena filled with young men. The challenge lies in taming the bull with bare hands. On the first day of the sport, on January 15th, around 680 bull tamers and 730 bulls took part in the popular game in Avaniyapuram in Madurai. Over 30 people were injured right on day one. Four of the critically injured have been shifted to Madurai Government Hospital. The Supreme Court refused to entertain a petition challenging the Madras High Court order on holding Jallikattu, ensuring the sport would be held without any hiccups. But can Jallikattu be seen on the same line as other sports? Certainly not. Here, the bull undergoes barbaric treatment before and after it is brought to the crease. The men trying to tame it also face physical harm. Apparently, the bulls are not physiologically suited for the sport. The Supreme Court judgment banning the sport had noted that the bull had a large abdomen and thorax, which limits the bull's ability to run. Also, it has two toes on each foot, and such animals can only walk and are not meant to run. The young men trying to tame the bull are not protected too. They do not have any safety guards on them, unlike other sports persons. Jallikattu is 1,500 years old. Since ancient times, the act of taming the bull has stood for masculinity and male power. So what does this sport stand for? Cultural pride or human supremacy?